everyone, I'm Sachini Dharmaratna from Kurunagala Rotaract Club. I'm a second year medical student at University of Kalaniya. So now I'm going to talk about the disease called thalassemia. I think the word is familiar because it's one of the most common diseases in Sri Lanka. So first let's look what this thalassemia is. It's an inherited blood disorder, which means it passed from the parents to children through genes. It is the most common single gene disorder. In this thalassemia, body makes abnormal form of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the molecule which transfers oxygen throughout the body. Due to this abnormal hemoglobin, it results in excessive destruction of red blood cells, which leads to anemia conditions. Thalassemia is most common in Asia, Middle East, Africa, and Mediterranean countries. If we talk about the causes of thalassemia, it occurs when there is an abnormality or mutation in genes involved in the hemoglobin synthesis. It is inherited as a genetic abnormality from the parents. If the child receives the defective gene only from one parent, the condition is known as thalassemia minor. Generally, the thalassemia minor patients do not exhibit the signs and symptoms of the disease, but they remain as carriers and they can transfer the defective gene to their second generation. If the child receives the defective genes from both of their parents, the condition is known as thalassemia major or thalassemia intermedia. This is the condition where the signs and symptoms of the thalassemia disease are exhibited, and the thalassemia major is the most severe form of thalassemia. Let's talk about the hemoglobin structure. Hemoglobin is composed of heme group and globular chains. It is made up of two proteins, namely alpha globin chain and beta globin chain. In this picture, in green color, alpha globin chains are indicated, and in yellow color, beta globin chains are indicated. So it's clear that the hemoglobin molecule is made out of two alpha globin chains and two beta globin chains with heme groups. When we take the types of thalassemia, thalassemia occurs when there is a defect in a gene that controls production of one of these proteins, which are alpha proteins and beta proteins. If the defect is in the gene which involves in the production of alpha globulin protein, the condition is known as alpha thalassemia. If the defect is in the gene which involves in the production of beta globulin protein, the condition is known as beta thalassemia, and that is how the thalassemia is categorized into two types. When we take the signs and symptoms of the thalassemia, there are many symptoms. They are fatigue, weakness. They also have a low immunity and they are easily prone to infections and diseases. They have a pale or yellowish skin. This is due to the reduction of red blood cells in the circulation. They have bone deformities, especially in the face, as depicted in the picture 2. In this thalassemia patients, bone marrow gets enlarged to produce more blood cells. As a result, bones also get widened, but the strength of the bones get reduced and they are easily prone to deformities or the fractures. They also show slow growth as well as abdominal swelling as in the first picture. They also have dark urine. This is a picture showing the features of face of a thalassemia patient. As you can see in this picture, they have small head, epicanthal folds, flat mid face, smooth philtrum, low nasal bridge, small eye opening, short nose, thin upper lip, and underdeveloped jaw. Let's see how to diagnose this thalassemia. It is diagnosed by a blood sample testing. In this blood samples testing, it is tested for the presence of abnormal hemoglobin, presence of abnormal red blood cells, or tested for ammonia. When we take the treatments for this thalassemia, the treatments depend on type and severity of the disease. Some of these treatments are blood transfusions, bone marrow transplant, medications and supplements, and also sometimes surgery to remove the spleen or gallbladder. Spleen is the organ which are involved in the destruction of damaged or old red blood cells. In this thalassemia, the red blood cells produced are abnormal and they are excessively destructed in the spleen. So to prevent this excessive destruction of red blood cells, spleen is removed from the surgeries. Let's finally talk about the habits to follow by thalassemia patients. They should eat a healthy diet to keep the bones strong and to provide energy. As I said before, they are easily prone to deformities of the bone and they are prone to fractures of the bones. Therefore, they should take a good diet to keep the bones strong and to provide energy. If thalassemia patients get ill or get fever, they should immediately consult a doctor. They should also stay away from sick people because they have a low immunity and they are easily prone to diseases and infections. They should not take iron pills because an iron overload can occur due to blood transfusions. Due to this iron overloading, vital organs like heart, liver, and endocrine system organs can be damaged. So to prevent this, they should not take iron pills. They can ask from the doctors about supplements like calcium and vitamin D. So this is the end of my presentation. Hope you guys get a good understanding about this disease, thalassemia. Thank you for watching.